I'm Justin Jedlicka, I'm 32 years old, and I'm a living doll. Acid daddy. I've had 125 procedures. And it's been $158,000 to make me really resemble a doll. And chest was first, then moved on to bicep implants, tricep implants, a brow bone shave. I had a brow lift. And I started having a couple other nose revisions. They all get a little fuzzy after a while. But at the end, I've had 5 nose jobs now.
So the doll really exemplifies sort of the ideal male aesthetic.
When I was probably about 12 or 13, I used to always watch Lifestyles of the Rich and Famous. And I always had this idea in my brain, I wish that my family could have been this family that was wealthy, and we could fly in private jets, and we could have our own boat. And that was always sort of a wish list. It was a dream in my mind. And I ended up sort of emulating what I thought a lot of those wealthy people look like. You know, they all had plastic surgery. And I realized that I had a liking for some more exaggerated features and this ideal male physique, you know, a little bit more like a doll, like a hero, you know, this like tiny waist and this large upper body. I live in Chicago at the Trump Tower. But I grew up in upstate New York with 3 other siblings. I'm the oldest of 4. I lived in a lower income family, and there wasn't a lot extra to go around. And the one thing that we could afford to do is for me to be able to buy paper and a pen and be able to sit down and sketch. Art gave me a way to sort of escape reality, a way to get away from all the chaos of my family life. I could put myself in any sort of fantasy realm and sketch it out. Now, I'm developing a customized muscle enhancement implant line at this moment. Playing around with the shapes to get an idea of the custom implants I want to have made for my next surgery. I didn't start wanting to look like a doll. It's sort of taken shape over the years. I started my plastic surgery journey at 17 years old. And I had made the decision to fix my nose. After my first nose job, my surgeries became more of a creative outlet. And I began to realize that I could actually build this ideal male physique. So like when you look at this implant piece, this is only 2 centimeters in height. And my implant piece is basically a 4. Eventually, we'll have Justin implants for everybody. So I was thinking it might be good if I looked into like just enhancing my eyes a little bit, maybe doing a little bit of permanent eyeliner.
What?
My mom and me have been best friends ever since I was a little kid. And whether or not she agrees with my surgeries, she's always there.
Justin, you're gonna end up looking weird.
Already there.
No, you're not.
I would definitely like him to stop if it was my choice. But I understand that that's part of his personality. He's not going to stop.
I just don't want you to look really odd then.
I'm still deciding.
Hi. Justin Jedlicka here to see Dr. Hayworth. Today I want to see Dr. Hayworth. I've made a consultation with him and looking forward to speaking with him about doing some abdominal implants that I've been working on for a while.
Hi. Justin.
Dr. Hayworth.
How can I help you today?
I get to be my own canvas and I get to create what it is to make me really resemble a doll.
Well, I've been thinking about ways to augment my abdominal muscles. Okay. About doing 6 or 8 of the abdominals. So I came up with some sketches. So we take a mold, and then it would require some cutting and separating, obviously, to sort of curtail them, but you'd have that basic contour of the abdominal muscles.
For me, my plastic surgeons need to be an extension of my own thoughts. So unfortunately, I need them because I can't be my own doctor. I can't be on the table and out and end and do my own surgery, or I probably would. So
you've had your lips done. You've had your nose done.
So, I mean, the lips, cheeks, as far as on top of the stems and the apples and the chin have all been silicone injected.
How do you afford all this stuff?
I spent $158,000 on procedures. And a lot of people questioned where that money came from, but I didn't take vacations. I didn't buy new furniture. I never bought a new car. I've had long-term boyfriends that, you know, said, what do you want for Christmas? Pecs. Instead of watches, I got biceps. You know? My biceps and pec implants will be with me long after any of that jewelry probably would be.
I wanted to flatten the brow bone that I had here. Mm-hmm. So I had to do a coronal cut across the top.
I always get a little bit apprehensive when I have patients that come in and they've had multiple procedures. They generally are seeking something that is perhaps unobtainable.
I have one small issue with the designs that I had. The anterior pieces on the front should have come all the way up to the clavicles. And this one's just way too low all over. And this one was actually put in backwards, believe it or not. So it's unfortunate he's working backwards. I get it, it's two pockets, you get confused, you got eight pieces.
Beauty is strategic imperfection. I think you really want super perfection.
Correct.
I'm a plastic surgeon, so sees a lot of stuff. With all due respect, you are conforming to common dictates of taste, but cartoon versions of it.
I'm not looking for someone to feel like they're the lead. I want to feel like I'm the one leading. I know what I want, and I know what my vision is. I mean, I just need the doctor to do what they've trained to do, which is dissection.
I have to think about this, because you do understand that these are all prone to complications. So it's not like saying, okay, I'm going to go sign you up. Much thought as you've put into it, mm-hmm. I deserve the same.
Yeah, yeah.
In terms of being able to put thought into this as well.
I agree.
It's great meeting you.
I appreciate it. Thank you so much for your time. What I sort of go with my motto is, if you can't give me what I want, then tell me up front and be up front, and I'd rather say, peace out. I'll do my own thing. And I'll find somebody that will be open to working with me, but I just need someone that's kind of forward thinking.